15 minutes after 10 o'clock, 73 degrees, sunshine outside the window on 8th Street. 92.1 WROI, WROIFM.com, streaming audio live, RTC Channel 5. Soon to be audio and video on RTC Channel 4. That's why Tim's in the studio this morning. Hey, Tim.
Morning.
How are you?
As long as I don't get blamed for all the outages, we're fine.
Well, of course you get blamed for all the outages, Tim. You've got to understand that, you know? Time now for the Chamber Chat Show. Amy Rowe is here from the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce, Executive Director. Hey.
Hello. How are you? It's Friday.
It is Friday.
I'm good.
That's right.
It's Friday.
You had a chamber meeting yesterday.
Yes, we did.
Okay.
Early in the morning. Still trying to catch up on some sleep from it.
Bring us up to date on what's happening with the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce.
So we've got a lot going on. I was just sitting there working on my emails, attempting to in between getting it to work and looking at all that we've got and trying to get us ready for the next week. So we've got some fun stuff and some meaty stuff and some cleaning up stuff. Okay. Chili cook-off, obviously that's coming up again.
October.
Yes, that is one of our absolute favorite events.
Isn't though, that's really a great event.
It is. And
Red Hot Car Show will be back.
Always and forever.
All right.
So I know Chris Peterson and his team, they're working on getting those details together. And we have another meeting coming up on the 24th. One of the neat things that we are that we worked out last year is we're going to add some teams this year, or at least space for teams, because that was one of the things that we were disappointed with, is that we had more individuals interested in being a part of it than we had space.
Okay.
So we talked to the Red Hot Car Show folks, and on the west side of 8th Street, we're going to add some additional space for teams.
Excellent.
So now we get to go back to the drawing board and figure out all the logistics of that and make sure that we don't have to tell anybody no. So we didn't know that was a problem until last year.
Okay.
I guess the event's growing and people are falling in love with it, and it's one of those kickoff events for the fall. So lots of planning to do, but everybody knows the date. So October, it's always the second Saturday in October, so it's October 14th, and same time, same place. We just got to work on some of those logistics.
Been around now for what, 24, 25, 26 years?
25 last year.
25 last year.
So this will be 26.
Wow, that's
which
cool.
Which is absolutely crazy.
That's
but
cool.
Really neat that it's continuing to go and that it's actually building in capacity. That's a good sign for an event.
Exactly.
Is that it's building and growing.
True.
So we look forward to that. And you know, the other stuff that we've got going on is probably not as fun and fluffy, but absolutely essential. I kind of like that stuff. I'm a little bit of a, you know, I love all the meaty stuff. So I had my intern, my new high school intern, Ethan Trottier.
Okay.
He was in today, and I've got him working on research for our policy. We had decided that last year we updated our bylaws and, you know, just looked at them with a fine-tooth comb. And this year we've decided that the model of the policy from 1985, which was great, but we would like to actually update that and build it out. So we are meeting collectively multiple times, and poor Ethan gets to do all the research. So he sat in the doorway today and told me that it was one of his favorite things. So I think I have the right intern for the fall, because he sat there for 2 hours and researched policies and procedures. So we're working on that and getting ready for our nominating committee, because we're preparing for 2018 and looking at three potential board seats. Well, actually two, because Gloria is going to put herself back on the for a second term. And so we've got two open board seats. And I was sitting there looking at the list of board members today and just thinking about how our board meeting went yesterday. And my board is continuing to grow together with myself. And I feel like we've got a really good board.
Okay.
And I think that we are going to add some new folks. We're looking at folks outside of the county, or excuse me, outside of Rochester, just to make sure we have that county designation. So
how long is a board term?
It is 3 years.
Okay.
And you can have two terms. So you can be reelected for a second term, and then you have to sit out a term before you can be reelected.
Okay.
So if a chamber member is interested in nominating themselves, they are welcome to do that. They can send that information to myself or Beth, and we can bring it to the nominating committee and see what they say.
Okay,
so,
excellent.
Lots of fun stuff there. And we had an interesting situation come that was brought before us. You know, every once in a while you get kind of fun and interesting situations, but we have the United Way, who has their house over here on Main Street,
right?
Meaning their office. And we had been approached, or we approached them at one point about that Ducky Derby. So everybody loves Ducky Derby.
That was fun.
It was fun. And we didn't want that to no longer be an event that's not happening in Fulton County. We didn't feel like it was a good fit for the chamber, but we felt like it's a good event. And so at one point we had spoken to the United Way and asked if they wanted to use it for as part of their campaign, and they declined last year. But this year they came back and said, hey, we are looking at wanting to be able to purchase the 211 service for Fulton County. And the increased price is not obviously doable with their budget currently. So they said, hey, what would it look like to potentially have that Ducky Derby and make that work with the Fulton County service provider? So we talked about it as a board, and we've got about 4 boxes of ducks down in the basement. And so they're just hanging out, you know, quacking down there, just waiting for their opportunity to be revealed for their, you know, debut again. And so we talked about it as a board and made the decision that we were going to gift our little duck friends downstairs and the event to the United Way so that we can provide an opportunity to have a resource for Fulton County that's absolutely essential. So we feel honored that we can do that and that the Ducky Derby might actually come back.
Tell us about 211.
So 211, obviously I'm not United Way, but Jenny Moriarty was my roommate in college, and she's a wonderful woman, and we've spoken about it. Basically, from the research that we've done, 211 is the, it's a website, but it's also kind of a phone call bank that they would house all the resources that Fulton County has. Let's say there's an individual that is in need. They need to know where can they get free tax services, or where can they get, where's the closest food pantry? And so without having a directory, we had, I guess, paper directories way back in 2009, but those things change every 2.5 seconds, so paper directories would have to be reprinted. 211 is an opportunity to have that directory and to have someone else manage it. And also, with that, you can call, but then they keep track of our calls. So they keep track of who's calling, what age they are, what needs there are. They can give that information to us as a community, and we can use that to see where we're missing in gaps. As far as, let's say, somebody calls about free tax, and there's no one who does that, so we can find maybe somebody who would be willing to do that. So it helps us to provide the needs, but to understand the needs at the same time.
Sounds like it'd be a very good service for Fulton County.
Great service. Sure. The problem is that as they, meaning United Way, not this one, but the United Way as a whole with the 211, are attempting to provide text access to that, so you can text in and ask for things. The price went up a bit, I guess. Obviously, nothing's for free. So the initial price that it used to be and the price that it is now, it's just not the same, and it jumped quite a bit. So this Ducky Derby would be able to provide an opportunity to have a fun event that goes for a great cause and provide another tradition for Fulton County.
Would they have that as part of the chili cook-off, or would that be a separate?
It would be separate. Okay. So we've had some collective meetings with the Fulton County Service Provider Group, the faith community. I think that they would probably do it sometime in the summer.
Makes sense.
Probably have it out at the lake like they did, because obviously those ducks have to have a way to get home.
They come over the dam, as I recall.
They do. Matt Strader, this is his favorite event, and I think that he may or may not. Well, I think he probably will, because I wish I could have seen it.
They put them all on one of his front end loaders, don't they?
They do, and they dump those dang ducks over. Get the ducks out of Dodge. That's what they do.
Exactly.
And so I believe that it will be great to be able to have that here, because from what I understand, it was a pretty neat event, and I just think that it needs to be used. I don't like to squirrel things away if we have to. I want to make sure that they're in the right home and that they're being used effectively. So I think that this was a good decision by the board. I think it will be a good decision for Fulton County.
Okay.
And we really feel honored to be able to have a small part in that.
Amy, basically, other things that came up at the board meeting yesterday?
Yeah, just working on some of those other events.
Okay.
We've got the final Women in Business on September 8th. So that is a panel discussion with some ladies. I'm finalizing who those ladies are.
Okay.
And Abby from the United Way in Kokomo, she's a dynamic woman and does a lot of speaking for women's groups in Kokomo. She'll be the moderator for that. And so we're excited about that. We haven't gotten the information up because I haven't gotten those the panelists, but save the date for that. So Friday, September 8th. And then Lakeside Kitchen. It's a renovated version of an old restaurant in Nina Lake. Mm-hmm. And Christy Overdorf, she purchased that.
Okay.
And she's building out a neat deck so you can overlook Nina Lake. And she's hosting us for a business after hours on September 19th.
Excellent.
So we need to get over to Nina Lake to Lakeside Kitchen at 4:30 to 6:30. And she'll host us there and we can see what she's up to.
Okay.
So lots of good stuff, lots of good events.
Amy Rose, Executive Director of Fulton County Chamber of Commerce. Any discussion about the community parade that was held a month or so ago and any changes that might be coming with that?
Lots of discussion.
Okay.
So obviously we do things, you know, in a kind of incremental way. And so we had our chamber discussion, we had the Rochester Downtown Partnership discussion, and then we had a collective discussion where we invited Chief Andy Schatz.
Okay.
We invited the business owners and some restaurant owners and looked at what makes the most sense, looked at all the information that we had received and the feedback. And so we had kind of come to a what we thought was a solution, and then one person said, hey, why don't you check into one more thing? So they requested that I go to the Moose Lodge and that I speak to them potentially about a partnership with one of their events.
Okay.
Because obviously collective events are better, and if we're all working together, then it helps make life easier. So we have proposed to them, or we proposed to them something, and then they counter proposed. So I have one more call to make, and then we're going to make a final decision. So
okay.
We're not 100% sure yet, but we're getting close. We want to make sure that the date and the time and everything gets out well before so people can prepare.
Sure.
But lots of lively discussion, and we want to make sure we make the right decision for all parties involved as much as possible. Nothing's going to be perfect, but as much as possible, we want to try to make sure it makes sense. Because like the Ducky Derby, we want to make sure that this is a viable tradition into the future.
So. Leadership Academy coming back?
Leadership Academy is coming back, and I actually get to attend this year.
Okay.
So I didn't get to attend last year, but I will be there. And that I believe that starts in September. They're finalizing the class list. They have their own board of directors. So we act as kind of that fiscal agent for them, but they get to make those decisions. And this year, I'm excited to be able to actually attend. I've been a speaker and understood, you know, what they've done, but now I get to experience from the inside out.
Okay.
So we're adding that here, and that'll just be a little bit more busy. But I think it's a good busy. I want to know all the resources that we have and make sure that we're...
Again, Amy Rowe, Executive Director, Fulton County Chamber of Commerce. Anything else you'd like to add this morning?
Yeah, we're continuing to work on tourism.
Okay.
You know, obviously that's still something that we're looking at spinning off, as is the model for most other communities. But meanwhile, we're ensuring that it continues to be successful and grows. So I have an interview for an intern to finish that website to help get the data collection and work on some videos that we're wanting to put on the website there. So she comes in this afternoon about 2:30.
Okay.
So she's from IUK, and she seems like a lively girl who is in the hospitality and tourism department over there at IUK. So
excellent.
Actually was there yesterday at IUK. Chancellor Giuseppe, she invited us all to her home for dinner, and I talked to her about her, and she said she's a good student. So knocking on wood that she'll say yes, and we'll be able to move forward. And then, you know, working on the you know, the collection and the expenditures and all the stuff that no one loves, but that I'm a nerd about and I love. We want to make sure that we honor the state code and that we're doing everything as it should be and that we're using the tool as effectively as we can. So lots of hard work.
I think a week from today, we talk with the Rochester Downtown Partnership. Mm-hmm. Anything along that line?
Yeah, you know, lots of stuff. Obviously, it's still... I'm the president of the board, you know, till the end of the year, just because of the fact that we're attempting to help to them launch. And we're looking at a part-time staff person. So we had proposed a part-time staff person. Then it was re-proposed that we propose a full-time staff person. But that probably isn't the most efficient use. So we are going back to what we originally proposed, which was that part-time staff person, and making sure the job descriptions and all of that is what it should be, and separation of duties. And they've got a lot of good stuff. They just did with IUK, Mason Heidi, myself and Terry, and Sarah looked at what the market analysis was that the IUK students, MBA students proposed to us. Really neat stuff.
Okay.
Really helpful. That was free of charge with a partnership with IUK, and the Rochester Downtown Partnership provided that. So we will be presenting that most likely at the FEDCO board meeting. So they've got a lot of good things that they're working on, building capacity and moving to the next level. They'll do their strategic plan in the fall again and figure out what we can do from a design perspective and events and economic vitality, working on the brewery project to see how we can move that forward and ensure that that is what it needs to be and just continue to build capacity for Fulton County.
Amy, why membership in the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce? Why should I join?
Well, this is the way I look at it, is that Fulton County Chamber of Commerce, we're a tool for individuals to multiply the efforts. One person can do one thing, but multiple people can do multiple things. So we work every day to make sure that we highlight those benefits and that we make sure that they're relevant and effective so that folks can use membership to build their business.
Amy Rowe, as always, thanks for your time.
No problem. Thank you for having us.
Thanks for being here.